Hi students, this is Viswanath, Chemistry Faculty for NEET and IIT exams. See the next topic in thermodynamics, cyclic process. Generally, many students feel confusion between cyclic process and reversible process. Now, see the cyclic process definition. A process in which initial state of system is regained after a series of operations, that is called cyclic process. That means, suppose a reactant is converted to products by following different steps. Again, that product is converted to reactant in the same steps. That process is called cyclic process. That means, from where we started that process, finally same substance is reached, attained after a certain series of operations. That process is called cyclic process. For this type of cyclic process, change in internal energy delta U equal to zero and delta H is also equal to zero. Delta H means change in enthalpy. This is change in internal energy. So cyclic process means a process started and converted to another stages, finally reached the same initial stage. That process is called cyclic process. Now, reversible process. The process in which all changes occurring at any part of the process are exactly reversed when change is carried out in opposite direction. Now, a process is taking place in different steps. At any step, if we change the reaction conditions in a opposite directions, then that process carried out in reverse direction, that is called reversible process. Understand carefully, a process taking place at any part of the process, if the change is carried out in opposite direction, then that process taking place in the reverse direction, that is called reversible process. Cyclic process means initially a stage is there, it is changed to another one, changed to another one, and again reached to initial stage, that is called cyclic process. Here, reversible process means by changing the reaction conditions, or if we conduct the same process in opposite direction, if we get back the original one, that is reversible process. Between cyclic and reversible, this is the difference. In reversible process, it gives rise to maximum work. Okay. Next important formulae. Work done in isothermal reversible expansion of an ideal gas. Isothermal reversible expansion. WREV equal to minus 2.303 into nRT log of V2 by V1. In terms of pressure, formula is minus 2.303 nRT into log of P1 by P2. V1 initial volume, V2 final volume, P1 initial pressure, P2 final pressure. So remember carefully, based on this, multiple choice questions come. Next, work done in isothermal reversible compression of ideal gas. Above one is expansion, here compression. W equal to 2.303 nRT log V1 by V2. Small difference between these two formulae. Here negative sign is there, V2 by V1. Here positive sign, V1 by V2. In terms of pressure, formula is 2.303 nRT log of P2 by P1. Here also same. Initial volume, initial pressure, final pressure. Next, work done in isothermal irreversible expansion. These two, reversible expansion, reversible compression. Here, irreversible expansion work done, W equal to minus P external into delta V. Already we know that delta V means difference in the final volume and initial volume, or Q equal to minus W, that equal to P external into delta V. Here W equal to minus P delta P external pressure delta V. Already here W having minus, so minus into minus plus, so P external into delta V. Next, free expansion. Expansion of a gas in vacuum is called free expansion. So if a gas expanded into vacuum, then there is no pressure on that gas. In that case, we can consider external pressure is zero. So P external equal to zero. No work is done during free expansion of an ideal gas, whether the process is reversible or irreversible. If a gas expanded into vacuum in a reversible manner or irreversible manner, P external pressure equal to zero, that therefore work done is zero. See this, pressure P external equal to zero, that implies W equal to zero. Next, see the numerical. An ideal gas of 1 mole undergoes expansion reversibly from 2 liters to 10 liters at a pressure of 1 atmosphere and 25 degrees Celsius. What is the work done in this process in joules? Okay, initial volume, final volume, pressure value is given, temperature also given. We should find out work done. What is the process? Reversible expansion. Note down N equal to number of moles, N equal to 1, temperature 25 degrees Celsius, and in Kelvin 298 Kelvin, pressure equal to 1 atmosphere. Here, what is the suitable formula? W equal to minus 2.303 nRT log of V2 by V1, final volume divided by initial volume. So N value 1, R value liter atmosphere, 0.0821 liter atmosphere mole inverse Kelvin inverse, temperature Kelvin value 298 into log of final volume divided by initial volume. So from this we can get work done equal to minus 39.3 liter atmosphere. Here we got negative value for work, that means work is done by the gas because here expansion takes place. So convert this value into joules. 1 liter atmosphere equal to 101.325 joules. So 39.3 liter atmosphere means we can get 3982.07 joules. So work done in the reversible process is minus 3982.07 joules. Okay. Next, first law of thermodynamics. Important one. Say this statement. The energy of an isolated system is constant. Isolated system, open system, closed system. Three types of systems are there. Isolated system means neither energy nor matter can exchange between system and surroundings. No exchange of matter, no exchange of energy between system and surroundings. That is called isolated system. Now, the energy of that type of isolated system is constant. There is no change in the energy of isolated system, or energy can be transformed. It means one form to another form. Heat energy to mechanical energy or heat energy to electrical energy. In this way, energy can be transformed from one form to another form, but cannot be created nor or destroyed. We cannot create any new energy or we cannot destroy already existing energy. Otherwise, this first law of thermodynamics we can mention in another way. The net energy change in a closed system is equal to heat absorbed plus the work done by the system. See this, the mathematical form of first law is delta U equal to Q plus W. Here, delta U is change in internal energy, heat gained or lost by the system. W means work done by the system or work done on the system. Here Q is positive, heat is absorbed. Q is negative, heat is evolved, that means released. Already we know that work done signs. W equal to positive, work is done on the system. W equal to negative, work is done by the system. Okay, students, remember these conditions carefully. We'll meet you in the next class.